Hey, crafting friends, this is Beth at Quitman Public Library, and I'm going to do an instructional video for you for your kit with the watermelon summer hanging. So what you'll do is you have the plaque here, and you'll do one strip that's black, then one white, black, white, and alternate. And just so we wouldn't get paint on the hanger part, I put some tape over that for you, so you can do that at home if you feel like you need to. And then we'll put a ribbon at the corner up here and a watermelon here when we get done. And just for the sake of time, I'm going to just do the front so you'll get the concept. And we'll start with black. And just get a good even coat of black on the front. And if you're nervous about going over to the next piece of wood, you can tape it off if you like with just a piece of scotch tape. Okay. And then we'll do this one in the middle. Ideally, you would let the black dry before you put the white on, but you may not have the time or not want to wait that long. So on this one, we're doing a watermelon, but if you have something different at your house that you'd like to put as an embellishment onto the wall hanging, that would be fine as well. And I'm not using water for this project because I want a nice thick coat of paint. So we'll go over to the edge one and do a nice thick coat of black paint on this side. So I'm thinking while the black dries that I'll come over and do the bow that we're going to put off center at the left corner. And what I've done with this, instead of making a traditional bow, we're doing a strip bow. And so this is about 16 pieces of ribbon. And they're just alternated in different colors, in the same color, coordinating colors as the watermelon, but just stacked into a little stack and alternated. You can do these bows in big bows as well if you have a larger project. And if you do a bigger bow, it's good to use wired ribbon. None of these are wired ribbons because our bow is so small in this project. So I just got a little piece of floral wire, which will be in your craft kit. And we'll pull that as tight as possible. twist it until I can get it to the right spot. Got black paint on me. And then once you get it twisted, you just start pulling it up and just kind of alternate the ribbon to where it stands up a little and sticks out. And you just keep working with it until it looks like you would like for it to look. And like I said, none of this ribbon is wired, but if it were wired, then you can, you know, you have a little bit more control over it. So you can do it like that and just kind of fix the colors that you like the best to be on the top. Okay, and that one seems like it's sticking down too far, so I'm just going to chop a tiny piece off of that, and I think that one's going to work. So now we're going to paint the strips between white, and you can also paint the back if you would like to. This one, I just decided just to paint the front. If you get out of the lines, don't worry too much. You can always go back with your black and touch it up.
Have you ever heard of a book called The Wives?
The what?
The Wives.
Okay. And so we're just covering each of these strips with white. So we're at the library, so if you hear discussions about books in the background, it's because we're at the library. Okay. So on the white paint is a little bit thinner than the black, so it may take more than one coat, but you'll have plenty of paint in your kit. And you can put just a little bit more pressure on the side of your brush to get it to go straighter. this one we'll have to go through and put some black paint to even that one. And need just a touch up right here. And some extra paint. Like there's a buildup of paint right there, so I'm just gonna take that off. Get a Q-tip and take the build up off some. And then you can see how this is kind of blended over and made a gray streak. But I sort of like that. You can keep yours crisp black and white if you want to, but I kind of like the, because it makes it look a little weathered and imperfect, and I like that. And I might want to do a few little streaks like that on the other one as well. Okay. And so then, The next step would be to put the bow on the corner. And I'm thinking maybe about right there. So I'm just adding a little glue to the back of that bow. And right there. And you can reposition it a little. Of course, at home you would be letting yours dry more. And then this would go about right here. So I put a little glue on the back of that. Place that right there. Then we'll need to take these pieces of tape off. So then that's the finished project. And I'm seeing right now we probably should have put some glue on each corner of the watermelon.